Hi, everybody. Thanks for coming along today to our morning press conference. My name is David McNeil. I'm the co-chair of the PAC committee, which organizes events at this club. While the lady sitting here beside me, Shoko Arai, was the only female member of the city assembly in Gunma's hot spring town of Kusatsu, but she was, of course, dismissed in a recall election on December the 6th. She says that the town's mayor, Nobutada Kuroiwa, groped her during a meeting at his office on January 8th, 2015, and he asked her indecent questions about her private life. The mayor denies those allegations. He was here, of course, on Monday, and he has filed a defamation suit against Arai-san. He claims that Arai-san and her colleagues are seeking to remove him from office on baseless accusations. After Arai-san published her story last year in an e-book, Mr. Kuroiwa filed a libel complaint with the police. Arai-san was expelled from the assembly in December 2019 with other members. The assembly said that she had hurt the dignity of the town. She claims, Arai-san says, that the male-dominated political system of Kusatsu, spearheaded by the mayor and the town's influential business figures, has punished her for speaking out about her ordeal. In August, the Gunma Prefectural Government ruled that her expulsion, her initial expulsion by the assembly, was illegal, and they subsequently restored her assembly seat. However, the assembly chairman, Takashi Kuroiwa, led calls for a referendum in the town and on when he should be called. And that campaign, which used posters calling Arai-san a disgrace, worked, and Arai-san was unseated a second time on December the 6th. So we have heard already from the mayor. Today we are going to hear from Arai-san. She's going to speak for about 15 minutes. Our interpreter over there, of course, is Mary Joyce. Yoroshiku onegaishimasu. Can I just remind you, if you haven't already, to switch off your cell phones, just so you don't disturb the speaker. Thank you.
最初の紹介の方は日本語は省略させていただきますが、本日のスピーカーは新井翔子さんでございます。携帯の電源の方を切っていただくようにお願いします。それでは新井さん、よろしくお願いします。
はい。本日はお忙しい中、このような機会を作っていただきまして、大変ありがとうございます。
So first of all, thank you very much for creating the opportunity for me to speak with you today.
黒岩町長から性被害に遭ったことは事実です。
It is a fact that I was sexually assaulted by Mayor Kuroiwa.
電子書籍でこのことを告白したことが原因で、私は2回も議会資格を剥奪されました。
I have been expelled twice from the local assembly because of the fact that I came out about this in an e-book.
町長や議長をはじめとする議員のほとんどが私の告発を嘘と決めつけ、リコール以前から私や私の支援者に中傷やデマなどの圧力をかけてきました。
Most of the council members, including both the mayor and the speaker of the assembly, branded my claims as lies. And since even before the recall, they have been pressuring both me and my supporters with slander and false rumors.
2019年12月2日の草津町定例議会で、いきなり除名という懲罰処分を、私は即座に議員資格を奪われました。
At the regular meeting of the Kusatsu Town Council on December the 2nd, 2019, I was all of a sudden given the punishment of being expelled and immediately disqualified from being a member of the council.
除名の理由は、議場内で私が告発したことは事実ですと発言したことが、町長に不快の念を抱かせた。議会の品位を落としたからということが理由です。
The reason given for the expulsion was the statement that I had made in the council chamber that my claims are the truth. It was said by the mayor that this statement offended him and that it hurt the dignity of the council.
黒岩町長が私を名誉毀損で告発した刑事事件や私を提訴した民事裁判の結果が出ていないにもかかわらず、草津町議会で荒井翔子が嘘をついていると決めつけた議員たちは、私の発言を信じて黒岩町長に対して不信任決議案を出した中澤康二議員に懲罰を科しました。
So even though the results of the criminal case in which Mayor Kuroiwa sued me for defamation and also the civil suit he filed me are yet to come, the members of the Kusatsu Town Council who decided themselves that they believe that Arai Shoko is lying imposed a punishment also on Nakazawa Yasuji, who was the councillor who believed my statement and submitted a no confidence motion against Mayor Kuroiwa.
除名処分に対し、私は群馬県の自治紛争委員会に不服申し立てをし、その結果、2020年の7月、県知事より除名処分は違法、処分を取り消すとの結果をいただき、正式に議員に復職することができました。
Following this, I filed an appeal against the expulsion to the Gunma Prefecture's Dispute Committee or Autonomy Dispute Committee, local Municipality Dispute Committee. As a result, in July 2020, the prefectural governor declared that the expulsion was illegal and that the punishment should be rescinded. And then I was officially reinstated as a councillor.
しかし、黒岩町長ほか、私に懲罰を科した議員たちは、この結果を不服とし、リコール活動を始めました。
However, Mayor Kuroiwa and the other council members who had imposed the punishment on me were unhappy with this result, and they launched a recall campaign.
黒岩町長は、私も共に戦います。町民の皆様に、荒井翔子の解職請求、リコール運動に賛同していただきますようお願い申し上げますと、自身のチラシを新聞折り込みに入れて、町内全域にばらまきました。
Mayor Kuroiwa then distributed his own flyers throughout the town and also enclosed them in local newspapers, flyers saying things such as, I will also fight, or I ask the people of this town to support the recall of Arai Shoko.
今年の8月に発行した黒岩町長自身のチラシには、知事に心血以前ですが、荒井翔子町議が議会に戻るようになれば、私と議会のメンバーは解職請求を断行します旨を伝えました。山本一太知事に心血前に、私が議会に戻ってくるならば、私と議会のメンバーは、リコール運動を団結しますというふうに知事に伝えましたとご自身のチラシに書いてありました。
So in a flyer which was distributed by the mayor himself in August of this year, he wrote things to the meaning that I have informed the governor that even though the decision has not yet been made, both I and the members of the council will make a decisive request for recalling of Arai Shoko if she is allowed to return to the council. So this was announcing his decision to go ahead with this expulsion or make efforts for this expulsion even though the hearing had not given its outcome yet.
審決の結果が出る前から黒岩町長は私をリコールすることを決めていたのです。
So this shows that even though the hearing had not made its verdict yet, had not given its judgment, the mayor had already decided that he would expel me from the council.
一町民が主役のはずのリコールが、町長や議員が主導をし、署名を集める代表者名簿には観光協会長や旅館組合長など、町内のそうそうたる面々が名を連ねていました。
So such a recall is supposed to be led by citizens. However, in this case, it was instead led by the mayor and by council members. Further, the list of representatives who were collecting the signatures to call for this recall included the head of the local tourist association and the head of the ryokan or the inn association and many other prominent people in the town.
それらの人々から署名や 投票を依頼されれば、依頼された町民は圧力と感じ、応じざるを得ないと思います。
If asked by such people to sign the position and, petition and to vote, I believe that the residents who were asked to do so would feel pressured and have no choice but to comply.
なぜなら、草津町は観光の町であり、議員のほとんどがホテルの社長、旅館の主人、企業の社長であります。そしてほとんどの町民がその従業員で構成をされています。
This is because Kusatsu is a town of tourism, and most of the council members themselves are either the presidents of hotel companies or the oyas of ryokan or traditional inns, and most of the local residents are their employees who are working under them.
社長や上司などから署名を依頼されて断れる従業員の方が一体何人いらっしゃると思いますか？
So how many people would actually be able to refuse to sign such a position or to vote when asked to do so by their boss or their employer?
草津町は小さな町です。署名についてはある人がしたしないが容易に分かってしまいます。また投票も誰が投票に来たか来ないかも容易に分かってしまいます。町全体が監視されていると言っても過言ではありません。
Kusatsu is a small town. It is easy to find out who has signed a petition and who has not. And it is also easy to find out who has voted and who has not. I don't think it would be an exaggeration to say that the whole town is under surveillance.
加えて町中に600枚ものリコールチラシが貼られ、連日、街宣車が走り回るという圧力的な雰囲気の中で、このリコール運動は行われました。
And on top of this, the recall campaign took place in a very pressurized atmosphere, with as many as 600 posters promoting the recall election plastered all over the city, and campaign cars driving around the streets day after day.
しかし、3317筆以上の署名が集まったのですが、投票総数は2750票と署名数を約600票も下回り、投票率も 53.66% と町としては低い投票率でした。
However, although more than 3,317 signatures were initially connected to support the election, the total number of votes which were actually cast was 2,750, so about 600 less than the original number of signatures. And the turnout was 53.66%, which is a very low turnout for the town.
このような圧力的な空気の中、私のリコールの反対に208名の方が投票してくれたということは本当にありがたく大変なことだったと思います。本当にありがとうございました。
So I can only express my gratitude to the fact that 280 people did vote against the proposal to expel me, despite being in very difficult circumstances or in the face of various pressures.
他にも様々な圧力がありました。
There were also many other forms of pressure.
町長を告発して以来、私と中澤康二議員が議会で何度も不当な懲罰に遭い、批判の嵐にさらされてきました。
Since I made my accusation against the mayor, both myself and Councillor Nakazawa Yasuji have been unfairly punished many times in the assembly and have been subjected to a storm of criticism.
私を擁護しようとすると、中澤康二議員が、私を擁護しようと中澤康二議員が発言をしようものなら、町長はそれ以上発言をするなら、さらに訴えますよ。損害賠償請求額を増やしますよと言い、議長が中澤康二議員の発言を止めにかかります。
So if in the council sessions, Councillor Nakazawa tried to speak out in defense of me, the mayor would say things such as, if you say any more, I will sue you even further, or I will increase the amount of damages I am claiming. The further, the speaker would also try to stop Mr. Nakazawa from continuing his statement.
それだけではなく、中澤康二議員は、中澤議員の親族が役員を務めるホテルの温泉を止めるぞとまで言われる事態になっております。
And not only that, but Councillor Nakazawa was even threatened that the hot springs to the hotel which his family or his relatives are the board members of would be cut off.
そして黒岩町長は、私に本当に性被害に遭ったのなら、平気な顔で私の目の前で座っていられるわけがないと言いました。傍聴席からは心ないヤジが飛んできます。まさに公開のセカンドレイプです。
Then Mayor Kuroiwa said to me, if I had really sexually assaulted you, then how could you sit there in front of me with an indifferent face?There was also heartless heckling or yelling from the observers in the assembly, and this truly was a kind of a public second rape.
このように黒岩町長はその権力を使って草津町議会から自分に不都合なものを排除し、草津町での居場所を奪い、人間関係をも壊すようなことをし、私を草津から追い出し、私の人生をも壊したいと考えているのでしょう。
So therefore, I think, well, does Mayor Kuroiwa want to use his power to exclude those who are inconvenient to him from the Kusatsu Town Assembly, to take away my place in the town, to destroy my relationships, to drive me out of Kusatsu, and even to destroy my life?
なぜここまでして黒岩町長は私を議会や町から追い出したいのでしょうか？
So why is it that Mayor Kuroiwa would want to go to such lengths to remove me both from the town council and from the town itself?
それはひとえに町長室での町長による性被害を私が公にしたからです。
This is purely because I made public the sexual assault by the mayor against me in his office.
このリコール運動にたくさんの方が今疑問を抱いています。
So many people do now have doubts about this recall campaign.
私が始めたチェンジオルグというインターネット署名でも1万5000人以上の人がリコール反対に賛同する署名をしてくださっています。
I launched an online petition on the website change.org and to date over 15,000 people have signed that expressing their opposition to the recall.
それはこの件がさまざまな問題を含んでいるからだと思います。
I think that this is because this particular case involves a number of different issues.
一つは人権の問題です。
One is the issue of human rights.
よく日本ではなぜ MeToo 運動が盛り上がらないのかという質問を耳にしますが、それは男性中心の社会の中で立場の弱い女性が声を上げにくい空気が作られ、潰されてしまうことを知っているからです。私がそうでした。
So we often in Japan hear the question about why the Me Too movement has not gained further momentum. But this is because we know that in such a male-dominated society, an atmosphere is created in which it is difficult for women in weaker positions to speak up and they are instead crushed. This was indeed the case for me.
一つは地方議会の問題です。
Another is the issue of local assemblies.
日本では女性の政治家が少ないことはよく知られています。
It is well known that there are very few female politicians in Japan.
女性ゼロ議会と女性一人議会を足すと全自治体の 40% を超えるそうです。
So apparently if you were to combine the number of either zero female councils or only one female councils, it would be more than 40% of all local governments.
日本社会の根強い女性蔑視が女性の数の絶対的に少ない議会という場ではさらに顕著に現れるのです。
And so the very deep-rooted condescension towards women in or looking down on women in Japanese society is even more pronounced in assemblies with such an absolutely small number of women.
今回、全国フェミニスト議員連盟が今回のリコール運動について抗議の声明文を発表し、 各関係団体の長に送ってくださいました。
In regards to this particular case, the Alliance of Feminist Representatives of Japan issued a statement of protest against the recall campaign, and they sent it to the heads of various related organizations.
その中で、日本では数さえ揃えば気に入らない人間は排除できるという立場の。
Within this statement, they wrote that in Japan, as long as you have sufficient numbers, you can exclude people that you don't like.
立場の弱い少数派の声は数の暴力でいとも簡単にかき消すことができると書いています。
And the statement also wrote that the voices of the minority in a weaker position can be easily drowned out by the violence of numbers.
草津町議会は象徴的だと思います。
I think that the Kusatsu Town Assembly is indeed symbolic of this.
私は今でも格差のない、権力者からの圧力に怯えることのない、みんなが生き生きと働き、生活できる町づくりを、すいません。私は今でも格差のない、権力者からの圧力に怯えることなく、みんなが生き生きと生活できる町づくりをしたいと思っています。
Even now, I feel very much that I want to work towards the ideal of creating a town where everyone can work and live with vitality, without disparity or inequality, and without fear of pressure from the authorities.
それを理想とし、今まで草津町で活躍をしてきました。
This is the ideal that I have held in all of my activities in Kusatsu until now.
その気持ちは変わっていません。
And this ideal, this will has not changed.
今後も草津町町議会を傍聴しながら、草津町の議会を監視していきます。
So I will continue to monitor the assembly of Kusatsu by observing the proceedings of the council from now and playing my part as well.
そして私の理想を実現できる活動を続けていきたいと思います。以上です。
And I hope to continue my activities working towards this ideal. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Okay, well, we are opening it up to questions. If anybody has a question, if you would show your hand to indicate that you want to ask and then come to the microphone and give your name and organization. I'll start with a question, and maybe it's sort of the question if you like. Kuroiwa-san, as you know, was here on Monday, and one of the things that he said, Arai-san, is that you have neither filed a complaint with the law enforcement authorities or a lawsuit against him. Do you want to explain why that is? Why have you not filed a complaint?
ではこれで質疑応答に入ります。会場の方からの質問を受ける前に司会の方から一つ質問をさせていただきます。ご存知のように先日黒岩町長がこちらで会見を開いたんですけれども、その時に町長が強調されていたことは、新井元町議がまだ警察にも提訴していない、そして裁判の方にも提訴をしていないということを強調されていたんですけれども、それについてのコメントがあればお願いします。
そのことについては、私は常に裁判も提訴も頭に入れております。
So in regards to that, I am consistently considering the option of making legal proceedings in the courts.
刑事告訴に関しては、実際に群馬県警の方に告訴したいということを申し出ました。
And in regards to a criminal case, I have indicated to the Gunma Prefectural Police that I am considering this.
私は黒岩町長から地元の警察と懇意にしている、地元の警察とよく知っている、通じているということを常に聞かされていました。
However, I have also always been told or heard of the very close relations between the mayor and the local police as well.
たびたび刑事課長を呼び出して、話を聞いていることも聞かされていました。
I've also heard about the fact that he is very often, for example, calling the head of the investigative department of the local police, to hear from him and to discuss with him and so on.
なので、地元の警察に行かず、群馬県警の方に行ったのですが、その時の対応に関しても、ちょっと不審に感じることがあったので、今は刑事告訴に関しては、検討保留にしております。
And so that is why I made the decision not to go to the local police, but instead to go to the Gunma prefectural police. However, there was also some aspects of the response or the stance by the prefectural police, which raised some concerns for me as well. Therefore, I have not officially filed the complaint with the police, but I am still considering the option and having a pending option of launching criminal proceedings.
民事裁判に関してももちろん頭には入れておりますが、私も今黒岩町長からの刑事民事で提訴されております。そして議会の中でさまざまな圧力、懲罰、そのような嫌がらせを食らせて、そのような嫌がらせをされている中で、それらの対応に追われておりまして、自分の刑事民事まで対応が及びません。
And in regards to a civil case, this is also something which I have been and I'm still considering. But at the same time, at the moment, I am experiencing, of course, being the subject of being sued for both criminal and civil proceedings by the mayor. Not only that, but I am facing various pressures and punishments and this negative treatment within the assembly as well. Therefore, at the moment, my capacity is indeed very much filled with just dealing with and responding to this current situation. And I'm not at the current stage of launching
精神的な余裕がない中なので、弁護士さんも今提訴されている事件や裁判に集中しましょうというふうに言っていただいているので、今そのようにさせていただいてます。
Because of, you know, my current mental or psychological capacity in dealing with this current situation that I am in, I am speaking with my legal advisors, my lawyers, and have been given the advice and have decided to instead focus on dealing with the current proceedings against me rather than looking at filing something new at this stage.
Thank you very much. If anybody has a question for Arai-san, would you show your hand, please, and let us know that you're in the audience.
ありがとうございます。ではこれで質疑応答に入りたいと思います。質問のあるワーキングプレスの方は手を挙げて、こちらの前のマイクの方から質問をお願いします。質問の際は所属とお名前の方をお願いします。
Lars first and then I see Teddy at the back. Don't forget to tell us who you are, Lars. Thanks.
My name is Lars Nikolaisen, German Press Agency, DPA. Thank you very much for your explanation. My question is, have you received support? You said you have received support from other people. Are there people among these supporters who have also experienced similar things, similar assaults by the mayor? Have there been other women who experienced that and have, even though maybe privately to you,but also reported to you that they experienced similar things? Is this a kind of prevalent thing? Is this a kind of atmosphere where such things not only happened to you, but also in the past to other women? Thank you.
のラズと申します。いろいろな方から支援を受けていらっしゃるという話があったと思うんですけれども、その話している方の中には同じように黒岩町長に被害を受けたという女性が他にいらっしゃるかどうかということについてお伺いします。新井氏ご自身だけではなくて他の方も、それを実際に経験された方、もしくはそれが容認されているような環境、雰囲気があるかどうか、それプライベートにも個人的にでも、そういったような被害の報告を受けているかどうかについてお願いします。
はい、黒岩町長から被害があったという報告は、他の方からも聞いております。
I have heard from other people reports of also experiencing similar assaults from the mayor.
ただその方たちに関して議会の中で黒岩町長は、誰がそんなこと言ってるんだって言いなさいよ、どこの誰だか言いなさいよ、何度も何度も私に聞きました。私は彼女たちのプライバシーもあるし、議会は公開の場ですので話せませんというふうに伝えました。
on numerous occasions, or after saying this, the mayor has then on numerous occasions within the assembly said to me, well, if there are other women, you know, tell me their names. Who is it? Who is saying that? He has asked me this on numerous times, but of course, considering the privacy of the other women involved, I have responded saying, well, this is the public space of the assembly, therefore I cannot give that information.
そのことに対して黒岩町長は、議会で言えないのなら嘘をついている、そのように私に決めつけて、やはり荒井翔子は嘘つきだというふうに言いました。
And in response to that, Mayor Kuroiwa would then say, well, if you're not saying their names, if you're not saying this information in the assembly, then you are lying and branding me, saying that 荒井翔子 is a liar. This is the response that the mayor is given in the assembly.
彼女たちは草津町で仕事をしています。先ほどお話ししたように、草津町は大変小さな町です。少しの情報でもあの人じゃないか、そのように決めつけられたり分かってしまう可能性があります。そしてそれが黒岩町長の耳に入ったら、私のように圧力に遭い仕事を失うのではないかというふうに大変怯えております。私も彼女たちを自分のような目に合わせたくはありません。なので何度も言いなさいよ、言いなさいよと嘘つき呼ばわりをされ、議会でも追及をされましたけれども、裁判中のこともあり個人のプライバシーに関わることですので答えられませんということで、そのように対応してきました。
However, these women, of course, are living and working in Kusatsu. And as I mentioned, this is a very small town. The smallest piece of information could lead to people giving rumors saying, well, is it her or it must be her, or finding out who the women involved or concerned are. And if this were to reach the mayor's or the ears of the mayor, then they would then experience the same pressure that I am also experiencing. So these women are indeed very fearful of being in that kind of situation, or indeed of even potentially losing their jobs. I, of course, do not want them to also go through the same experience, the same suffering which I have been going through as well. Therefore, no matter if I am being pursued in the assembly or being called a liar in these kind of situations, considering their privacy and considering also the ongoing legal proceedings, I am responding by not giving their names, by not saying who it is that these women who have said that they have also been assaulted.
Thank you. Are you at liberty to say, of course, you cannot reveal their names, but are you at liberty to say how many women have privately contacted you to say that they were assaulted by the mayor?
もちろんお名前の方などもちろん言っていただくことはもちろんないと思うんですけれども、何名ぐらいの女性がそういう被害を訴えているのかという情報はもし差し出さなければ教えていただけますでしょうか。
私が聞いているのは2名、あとはセクハラ発言とかまで入れるのであれば、私はあと1名、合計3名です。
So I have heard from two other women who have experienced a similar thing. And if we were also to include harassing statements, there is one further woman. So three other women.
Thank you. Just let me get Teddy's question first. Teddy, you want to ask your question and then we'll come back to you.
よろしくお願いします。ビデオニュースの神保と言います。その草津の今回の件でですね、いろいろ言われている中の一つに時間湯とか、あるいは湯長の廃止をめぐるですね、何かこう意見の対立なんかが関係しているというようなことを読んだり、あとちょっと一部聞いたりしてるんですけれども、ちょっとなかなかここのガージン記者クラブの面々はそういう慣習にも全然詳しくありませんので、そもそもその、時間湯とか湯長というのがどういうもので、それで、それが今どういう対立があり、で果たしてそれがじゃあそれがこの今回の件に関係しているということについて、荒井元将棋の方でですね、それは全く関係ないなら、全く関係ない、あるいは何らかの関係があるんであれば、ちょっとその辺の 関係性についてコメントいただければと思います。
My name is Jimbo of Video News. In regards to this particular case, one of the things which has been reported or mentioned is that this case is related to a difference of opinion between yourself and your mayor about the so-called style of bathing, which is known as jikanyu, or the bathing for periods in very high temperatures, and about the dispute over whether to cancel this form of traditional bathing or not, and so on. This is perhaps something which is not so familiar for the international press, but I wonder if you could explain a little bit, first of all, what this particular bathing style is and what the conflict over this issue is, and your opinion about whether that is related to this case or not.
時間湯に関しては、私は全く関係ありません。黒岩町長のように関与しているということは全くありません。で、今、まあ、時間湯に関して説明をということだったんですけど、まあ、私が関与してない以上、この件には関係ないということと、140年もの歴史のあるものに関して説明をするのはとても時間がかかるので、説明に関しては割愛をさせていただければと思います。
So I would say that this issue about the dispute over jikanyu or the bathing styles is something which has no connection to this particular case. Although the mayor claims that there is engaged in this issue and says that it is connected, I do not believe that that is the situation. Because I'm not engaged in this and this is not a connection to the case, I will therefore, although there was a request to explain what jikanyu is in this form of bathing, I will refrain from giving the explanation of that. Also for the reason that it is something which has a very long history of 140 years, so it would indeed take a quite lengthy amount of time to explain.
Thank you. The lady at the back.
Hello, my name is Ariel Buzet. I'm from the Japan Forward, the English side of Sankei Shimbun. I have two questions. The first question is actually a follow-up on the first question by the moderator. You said that you gave your justification, explanation as to why you haven't filed a criminal and civil case. But I wonder if you could try to aim your answer also to people who accuse you of, for example, but if you don't file a case, maybe you're afraid that people will find more evidence, or maybe you don't want people to find more evidence, because those are some of the things that the mayor said the other day at the press conference. What would you say to people accusing you that maybe you don't want to file this case at all? And then the second question is if you could give us a little bit more background on how you decided to publish your opinions in an e-book, please. Thank you.
はい、産経新聞の英文のサイトのジャパンフォーワードの記者です。2つほど質問がありますが、まず1つ目は先ほどの司会からの質問 の補足といいますか、関連の質問なんですけれども、先日も黒江町長がここで発言をされたときに、もう1つ、提訴をされていない理由としましては、提訴したらもっと証拠が出てくるのか出てこないのかとか、その情報出てきてほしくないんでしょうというような発言があったんですけれども、それについてのコメントがもしあればというのが1つ目の質問です。そして2つ目の方なんですけれども、電子書籍で、この告発されたということなんですけれども、その電子書籍に、それを書かれるような背景の説明をもしお願いできればということです。
はい、証拠については今私は裁判で係争中ですの で今まさにこれから裁判では真実性について争われるところですので、やはりその前にそれら証拠を出すということは妥当というか、判断が難しいということで、証拠の方は出していません。先生、コメントしますか？
So first of all, in regards to the first question about any more evidence either, coming out in court and so on, because of course we are in the midst of court proceedings at the moment where I'm being sued by the mayor. One of the things which will be questioned within these proceedings is indeed the factuality of the case as well. Therefore, it's very difficult to make a judgment about bringing forward or putting evidence forward before these proceedings are actually going through their full course.
あと電子書籍に私が告白をした背景ですが、まず先ほど申し上げましたように、黒岩町長は長野原警察という地元の警察と大変に密接な関係があるということを繰り返し繰り返し私に話をしていました。それは事件があった前も後もです。 And
in regards to the e-book and my coming out with my claims being published in this e-book, as I mentioned, Mayor Kuroiwa has a very close relationship with the local police, the Naganohara police. This is something which I repeatedly heard from him many times, both before the incident and after as well.
なので黒岩町長はなぜ警察に行かなかったんだ。議員の皆さんもなぜ警察に行かなかったんだ。何度も何度も私に言いました。でもやはり先ほど言ったようにそのように何度も何度も聞かされていて、実際議員として地元の宴会に行って警察署長が座っているところを見たら、とても告発に行く気持ちなんかなれないということはご理解いただけると思います。あと先ほど地方議会の問題ということを申し上げましたが、日本では地方議会というのはほとんど注目をされません。ほとんど詳しい内情や地方議会のことに関して報道されることはありません。なのでどこに私の告発を伝えたらいいのか、そのように悩んでいたときに、ちょうど飯塚礼二さんというライターの方が草津町議会について記述をしている書籍がありました。中には草津町議会の中の様子について詳しく書いてありました。なのでここでだったらと思って、ちゃんと取り扱ってくれるんではないかと思ってお話をしました。以上です。
And so, of course, and being in a situation where over many times the mayor would be asking of me, you know, why are you not going to the police? If something happened, why are you not reporting the police? This being repeated or being said over and over. But as I mentioned, because of this very close relationship between the mayor and the local police, I was very concerned about this. You know, it was a situation where you would go to a local gathering or a local dinner and so on, and it would be the head of the local police who would be sitting there in front of you, you know, with the politicians as well. Therefore, very difficult to feel that it was the kind of environment where it would be okay to stand up and to talk about this. Another factor is, as I mentioned, about the issues of local government in Japan as well. Internal issues or discussions, debates within local governments in Japan also are things which do not really receive very much attention. They are not reported very widely in the media, for example. Therefore, when I was thinking about, well, where would be a kind of place where I could tell my story, where I could come out about the assault which had happened to me, was when I heard that there was a writer called Iizuka Reiji who was about to publish or was writing a book very detailed looking at the internal and the politics in the town of Kusatsu. Therefore, I believe that being that he was writing very detailed about these issues, that that could be a space where perhaps my story or my claim would be treated fairly. So I decided to speak to him and have my claim published in his ebook.
Just on that subject, if I could ask a follow-up question. So the you said the assault happened in 2015 and the ebook was published in 2019. Arai-san, do you just want to like explain to us your process? So that was 4 years. You waited 4 years to write this book. Was there ever a point where you thought you might not, you just might give up, you might not continue fighting?
一つ、まあ、関連なんですけれども、まあ、事件があったというのは2015年、そして電子書籍が出版されたのは2019年だと思うんですけれども、まあ、その4年の間の、まあ、どういう過程があったのか、まあ、その間に、まあ、もしかして告発せずにもう諦めようかと思ったことがあったのかなどについて、もしコメントあればお願いします。
はい、告発しようと諦めたことがあったのかという質問については、もう被害に遭ったときに、そこはもう告発は諦めました。なぜかというと、やはり信じてもらえないんではないかということが頭の中にありました。先ほど警察に行ってももみ消されるだけ。しかも町長室なんて私だってまさか信じられない。だからそんなことを言っても誰も信じてくれないだろう。そういうふうに思って、やはり2015年の事件の時には諦めました。これはもうずっと自分の胸にしまっておこうって、そういうふうに思いました。
So first of all, about whether I did think that I might give up. At the very time that I was victimized, already from then, I had actually given up on the idea of speaking out about this. The reason being that in my head, I thought that even if I were to say something, that nobody would believe me. If I were to go to the police, then this would just be rubbed out. And, you know, thinking about the fact that this was from the mayor and where it happened, I thought that perhaps I wouldn't even believe myself. You know, this was something that meant that at the time in 2015, when the victimization happened, I thought already then I will give up on ever speaking to anybody about this, and I will just have to keep this to myself.
しかしその後私は次の選挙に落選をして、まあ、議員ではなく一般町民に戻ったわけですけれども、その間に議会の傍聴は続けてました。やはり落ちたからもう町民のために仕事をしない、落ちたからやはり町の町を良くする仕事をしないというのは違うんではないかと思って、やはり議会の傍聴を続け、議会の監視をするべきだと思って傍聴していました。でその中でやはりどんどんどんどん強権的になって、どんどん独裁的になっていく黒岩町長の姿というのを議会で見ていきました。そしてやはりその状況を変えていかなくてはいけないと思って、まあ、昨年町議会議員に立候補をして当選させていただいたわけなんですけれども、その時の議会で共産党の新人議員さんが自身が発行した発行物で、議会でやはりその発行物の内容について責められているのを見ました。その議員は共産党の議員さんです。町外から来て、やはり初めて草津町の議員になった方です。
So I felt, you know, of course, at first that I would not speak out about this. However, after that, there was another election where I ran to continue as a councillor. However, I was unsuccessful and returned then from being a member of the assembly to another general resident. However, I continued to attend and observe the assembly proceedings after that. I felt that even though I was no longer an elected official, I did not want to stop my work in being active or working to improve the townof Kusatsu, so I continued to attend, observe, and to monitor. And within this experience, I saw more and more the mayor becoming, you know, more aggressive, more dictatorial in the way that he was running things in the town as well. And I felt that we needed to change something about that situation. We could not let things proceed as they were. Therefore, last year, I decided to run once again in the local election, and this time I was successful and re-elected to the council.Then when I did come back to the assembly, there was another member, a new member, who was elected to the council from the Communist Party in Japan. And they were someone who came from outside the town, and they were elected for the first time in Kusatsu. And they were being attacked for some contents which were published in their own publication.
確か5月の一番最初の頃の議会だったと記憶しています。彼がどういう内容の広報誌を出したかというと、新草津という共産党の草津の共産党の広報誌ということで出したのだと思います。内容は草津町民からの投票ということで、草津町民からの意見ということで、黒岩町長にはもっと町民の意見を聞いてもらいたいと、このままでは独裁的な政治になってしまうではないかという懸念の内容の投票でした。読者からの意見です。
And I remember that this was around the start of May. It was the first assembly proceedings of that month. And the content which was being published in this local Communist Party paper, which was called New Kusatsu or Shin Kusatsu, was including opinions which had been sent in from residents who were saying that they wanted the mayor to be listening more to the opinions of the local people, that he was becoming more and more dictatorial.
で、その彼の広報誌の内容に関して、町の議会に陳情が入りました。なんでそんな内容を掲載したのか、その理由が知りたいという町民からの陳情でした。
And so after that, there was a complaint which was issued by the town saying, why are you publishing these kind of contents in your PR flyer?
町長の同級生からの陳情でした。
And this came from a classmate of the mayor.
議会では全員協議会が開かれて、なぜそれを掲載したかということが議論になり、最終的に彼は謝罪、そして訂正文を掲載することを承諾する事態になりました。
And so then, because of this claim which was submitted, this was then something which became an issue of debate or discussion within the assembly proceedings. And it ended up in the situation where the member concerned was, in the end had to make an apology and recall or revise what he had published in his paper.
その様子を見て私はとても疑問に思いました。これは自由な意見が町民も言えなくなってしまう、町政に対して自由な発言、意見が言えなくなってしまう、これは大変な問題だと思いました。
And so seeing this, it made me question very deeply whether we were in the kind of circumstances where even the local citizens would not be able to freely give their opinions about local politics anymore.
まして彼は町外から草津のために、草津町民のために仕事をしようと思って来てくれた方です。そしてまだ1年生議員で何もわからない最初にそのような議会で批判の意見をぶつけられて本当に怖かったと思います。
And so the fact that, you know, this, the new member was someone who had come to Kusatsu wanting to do something for the town, to want to work for the better of the town. And was also still in his first year as a member, you know, still very new, still learning the ropes and so on. But to be suffering or going through such criticism, I think must have been very fearful for him.
彼の気持ちを聞いたわけではないですし、それが原因かどうかは分かりませんけど、彼は今私のリコールのメンバーに入っています。
And you know, I haven't heard his feelings or his opinion about this or any particular reasons, but he has also been one of the members calling for my recall.
共産党のメンバーということで、やはり私のリコールのメンバーに入っているということをたくさんの方に驚かれて聞かれます。
すみません、リコールのメンバーというのはリコールに賛成している。
まずリコールに賛成している議員の中に入っているということです。
So just to clarify, so the fact that, you know, he is now one of the members who is calling for my recall, who is supporting the recall, I think is something which is surprising even for many members of the Communist Party.
なので聞かれたときは私はこの説明をしています。
So this is the explanation that I give when I am asked about this.
Thank you. Now we have time for one, perhaps two short questions. Lars, did you have another question?
Yeah, just a quick one.
And then the lady beside, yeah.
Just a quick question. Have you thought about or have you already taken action to reach out to other regions? I would assume that an atmosphere like this, maybe not as terrible as in your town, but there are women who face similar pressures, who are feared for whatever reason to speak out, to even if it's not sexual assault, but other things where they think they are suppressed, they are living in fear. Have you tried to put this on a kind of national level to make this case a bigger case? Because it's not only about Kusatsu, as you pointed out. Thank you.
はい、一つの質問なんですけれども、他の地域で、草津以外でも、おそらく同じような、性暴力、性被害でなくても、例えば圧力がかかっているですとか、抑圧されている、そしていろいろと、似たような状況にある女性が、他の自治体、他の日本の地域にもいらっしゃるのではないかと思いますが、全国的な、例えば他の自治体、他の地域の女性との連携ですとか、連帯というようなものが、もし何か行動されていることがあればということです。やはりこれは草津の問題だけではないということも先ほどおっしゃってたと思いますので、それについてお願いします。
はい。今やはり日本で女性議員が不当な懲罰に遭っているという事例が私のところにたくさん耳に入っております。
I am hearing of many cases where female politicians in different parts of Japan are going through very unfair punishments and so on.
確かに不当な懲罰ということに関しては男女関係なく男性の方も報道されているケースがありますが、ただやはり先ほど申したように女性議員の絶対的な数が日本で少ない中、やはり比較すると女性議員の不当な懲罰というのは 圧倒的に多いと考えています。
And of course, there are also, you know, male representatives, male politicians who also experience, you know, unfair treatment, unfair punishments, and so on within Japan. It is not something which is only dependent upon gender, but related to the fact that I mentioned that there is such an absolutely low number of women who are in politics, who are members in Japan, I think means that when you compare this, it is overwhelmingly more women who are experiencing such a situation.
先ほど申し上げましたが、フェミニスト議員連盟の方々が抗議文を出してくれたということをお話ししましたが、
その、As I mentioned, the Alliance of Feminist Representatives of Japan did issue a statement.
私が本当に一番最初、大変困っているときに、そのフェミニスト議員連盟の方からご連絡をいただき、いろいろ支援をいただきました。そして、その方の、またご友人のメンバーの方とか、温かく応援して支援いただいて、そしてやはりこの前私が東京でちょっとした報告会を持った時にもやはり埼玉の方からやっぱり懲罰不当な懲罰にあったという方が私の話を聞きに来てくれましてやはり実際に話を聞いてみて見ないとわからないとやっぱり実際に自分が聞いてみてどう思うかというところで来てくれたんですけどやはり応援したいということで今そういう形でやはり不当な懲罰を受けた女性たちが今声を上げようということで大変努力をしています。まあ、そのフェミニスト議員連盟の抗議文っていうのも一つその形になっていると思いますので、私も本当に感謝を申し上げてますし、自分も諦めずにしっかり声を上げていきたいと思ってます。
And so when at the very first, when this became an issue, when I was going through a very difficult time, it was this alliance who first reached out and contacted me and, you know, someone from there who first provided support and then also connected to more, you know, other friends, members and so on who have been since then providing warm support. When I had the opportunity to give a very small, you know, report session or present about the situation here in Tokyo, there was also a woman who came from Saitama. And after hearing my story saying that she wanted to hear it, directly then said that she had also experienced very similar things and wanted to support that. So we are seeing that there are more women coming out and raising their voices or making efforts to do so about receiving such kind of unfair punishment or treatment and so on. And I think that the statement by the Alliance is one tangible format which has helped that to come out in some way.So in regards to that, I am indeed thankful, and it is also encouraging me to not give up and to keep speaking out and to keep having my voice heard as well.
Thank you. Can you take, Arai-san, can you take a couple more questions? We're out of time, actually.
まだ12時となりましたが、もう少しお時間はよろしいですか？
あ、私は大丈夫です。
Okay, there's two questions. So the lady in the front here, and then Teddy wants to ask the second question, and then we'll end it there. Thank you.
この最後2つの質問を受けて最後にしたいと思います。
AP 通信の山口と申します。今日はありがとうございます。先ほどの質問にもちょっと関連してるんですけれども、この草津町で新井さんが経験された問題というのはあまりにも、町のその権力構造ですとか女性蔑視の問題、ものすごくいろいろ深い問題が複合的に合わさってると思いますが。女性皇位1点でその議会にいらっしゃった告発されるまでの間にもやっぱりそういう不当な扱いや嫌がらせをお受けになったことがあるかどうかそれは女性という理由でのことかあるいはその先ほどお話になったようなその草津町独特の権力者の中に議会が取り込まれているような構造であって男女を問わずそこに入ってない人が外されているということなのか、そこはどうお考えになりますか？
My name is Yamaguchi of AP. I would like to ask a somewhat related question. I think that this issue and your experiences in Kusatsu is also related to the various, you know, power structures, the denigration of women, looking down on women, and these complex issues as well. I would like to ask, first of all, if, you know, as the only woman in the local assembly, if you were experiencing such kind of negative treatment before you spoke out about the incident from the mayor as well, whether it is also, you know, to do with the fact that you, as the only woman, and these very peculiar power structures in place in Kusatsu,were a part of that, and also not only just about gender, but you know, about excluding someone who is coming from the outside and so on.
やはり草津町というのは、 温泉の町ですので、やはり独特の文化っていうのはあると思います。そしてやはり数少ない権力者で多くの町民が従業員という中で、やはり女性というのはとても立場が弱いですので、その中で、女性として不当な扱いを受けたというような話はよく耳にはしていました。
So Kusatsu is of course an onsen town, a hot springs town, and it has a very particular environment which comes as part of this. This is related to the fact that, you know, the small number of people who hold the power both politically, also economically have the power in regards of the fact that they are the ones who are employing many of the residents there as well. On top of this, many of the women are in more relatively weaker positions as well. So we often have heard, even, you know, before this situation, about women's position being in these kind of difficulties.
これは私のケースですが、やはり議会に入る前にもそういう性的な被害というのはありました。やはり私は町外から来て、とても立場が弱い人間だったので、やはりとても親切に助けてあげるよというような声掛けから始まっていきました。また私が議員になった時、草津で一番最初に知り合いになった議員さんにいろいろ政治のことを教えていただいていたんですけれども、その人の講演会の方から、もう彼とはそういう性的な関係になったのかっていうことを聞かれて、私はとても驚いてしまったんですね。なんでそんなことをいきなり言うんだろうって。その時に、あ、草津では女性を応援してあげる、支援するということに関しては、その裏側にそういう関係が関わってくるっていうのが前提なんだっていうのを、その時噂で聞いていたことが初めて自分の耳に入ってきて、納得したっていうふうに感じました。もちろんその人とはそんなことはなかったんですけど、それだけに私本当に入ってすぐの話だったので、とても驚きました。そういうことがありました。
And in my case as well, even before I entered the local assembly, I also experienced other forms of, you know, sexual victimization as well, as someone who had come from outside the town and was in more of a weaker position. You know, it would start from someone saying that they would be kind and they would help you out, show you the ropes and so on, and things would go from there. In one particular case, there was the first council member that I got to know who would also be the person who taught me a lot about, you know, the different local politics and how to work within that field. One of his supporters asked me whether I was already having sexual relations with him. I was extremely shocked when they asked me that all of a sudden. But then it came to, or I came to realize that a rumor that I heard about the same time, that to support a woman in Kusatsu also is automatically assumed to come with the fact that there is some kind of a sexual relationship connected there as well. So I'd heard this rumor, and when his supporter asked that of me, it all of a sudden really made sense.Or connected in that way as well. Of course, I did not have that kind of relationship with the council member in person, but I was very shocked to hear that this was indeed the kind of situation which was taken for granted there.
Thank you. And then the final question is from Teddy.
これで最後の質問となります。
If you can make it a short one, Teddy, that'd be great. Thanks.
すみません。ビデオ主の神保です。一つ確認なんですけども、町長も言ってらしたと思うんですけども、荒井町議から山本一太知事にね、なんかこう、メールが来て、でその中で時間用の復活を検討してもらえるんであれば、今回の告発は見送るっていうようなことを2回も言ってきたんだっていうような話が聞かされてたんですけど、今日ちょっと資料を拝見したら、そのメールを送られたのは、荒井さんご自身ではないっていうことなんですね、はい、で荒井さんは全くそれには関与してなくて、そういうつもりもなかったと、はい、いうことなんですね。まずちょっとそこのメールの、じゃあそのなぜそのようなメールが送られたのかの経緯ということと、ご自分に関係のない、ことが、そのご自分に関する性暴力に関して不問に付すみたいなことが、メールが送られたのがなぜかということとが一点とですね、それから、現在はちょっとさっき似た質問がありましたけれども、町長側が今、荒井さんを訴えている状況なわけですから、これが仮に無罪 罪になったとしても、これは新井さんが勝ったとまでは言えないわけで、新井さんの方が逆にですね、今回その性暴力、強制性交なり強制わいせつなりで町長を今度それが終わってからなんていうことになるのかもしれませんが、告訴されるご予定はないのか、時効の関係からいくと強制わいせつだと7年ですよね、強制性交だと10年ありますけれども、なのでその辺も含めて安倍さんの方から法的な措置を取られるご予定はないのか、その2点お願いします。
So I have two last questions. The first is in regards to a statement that the mayor made when he was here earlier this week. He said that there was an email sent to the governor Yamamoto of Gunma Prefecture saying that if he would reconsider allowing the Jikanyu bathing style again, then the scandal, the accusation against the mayor would be withdrawn. However, looking at the materials, it seems that these mails did indeed, of course, not come from Ms. Arai yourself and that you were not involved in this. I would like to ask if you could explain a little bit more about how or why these mails were implicating you or saying that there was this connection to your case if you were not involved. So first of all, an explanation of that. And the second, in regards to, well, as you mentioned, the mayor is currently suing you in two different cases. If you are found not guilty in those, are you considering to file your own suits after that, especially considering that the statute of limitations for different kinds of forcible sexual relations and so on, the two different kinds of laws, one is 7 years and one is 10 years, so what your plans after that are?
山本一太知事へのメールについて、前回の会見でもあったと思いますが、黒岩町長は私と飯塚氏が組んで山本一太氏にメールを送ったというような表現をしていたかと思います。しかしこのメールに関しては私は全く関与しておりません。私はその送った経緯すら知りませんでした。でそのことについてはこちら配られた配布資料のこちらの2面になりますが、こちらの方に日本語ですが明記してあります。
And so, first of all, in regards to the email sent to the governor, this was something that the mayor mentioned in his press conference. I believe that he said that Iizuka and Arai conspired to send these mails together. However, it was mentioned. I would like to say clearly that I have no involvement in this. Apologies, the interpreter did not have the materials which are being referred to. So first of all, I would like to say clearly that I had no involvement in these emails being sent. In fact, I did not know even what led up to them being sent in the first place. And the clarification of this is being included, these emails in particular are being included in the center page of the documents which were distributed today.
この中に書いてあるんですが、とても残念なことなんですが、この書籍の内容に関しては発行前に私はチェックすることができませんでした。とても残念ながらチェックしないで発売をされてしまいました。
Another fact which is very unfortunate actually is that this ebook was published before I had an opportunity to actually look at the contents that were being included in that to have any kind of check of what was being submitted and so on. It went ahead and was put up for sale.
私は黒岩町長にこの議会との親決がありましたので、これはまず飯塚さんにこの部分を抗議をして、このように彼もこの文章の中で「このことは新井元議員の知らないままに書籍化されたもので、真摯にお詫び申し上げ」というふうに、これは彼のブログの方に彼の文章として公開されているものです。
And so because of the ongoing situation within the assembly and so on, I did make a protest to the writer, Mr. Iizuka, about the fact that my words had been published in this way without me actually having the opportunity to check them. And he did after that publish in his blog words, which are quoted within the papers here as well, apologizing for publishing this for sending this without with Ms. Arai being aware of it.
なので、私の書籍を読んで、疑問に思った方も、疑問に思う部分あった方もたくさんいらっしゃると思うんですけれども、それは一つこういう背景があったということです。
So I think that there may be some people who, after reading my words that were published, may have had some questions and so on, but this fact or this background is connected to that issue.
なので、まあ、これからまたいろいろ対応も考えることもあるかと思いますが、それは検討中ということにさせていただいて、少なくとも山本石田知事のことに関して私は本当に全く関与していません。
And so in regards to how to respond to this from now, there are various things under consideration still as well, but I would like to say that I was not at all connected with this issue in regards to the governor.
黒岩町長はこの新聞にも書いてありますが、たくさんの嘘をついています。
As is printed here as well, Mayor Kuroiwa has been making many lies.
彼の心情は嘘も100回つけば本当になる。これは彼からも彼の同級生からも何度も何度も聞かされた言葉です。
And his way of thinking is that if you say the same lie 100 times, then it will become real, it will become the truth. And this is something that his classmates actually had said to me.
今まさに私にその言葉を行使しているところというのをものすごく実感しています。
And I very much feel the reality of the fact that he is indeed using this. He is indeed, that is what he is doing now.
私が嘘をついていないことは、これからしっかり裁判で明らかにしていきます。
So I will be from now within the courts making clear of the fact that I am not lying.
彼は言葉巧みに私がまるで嘘をついて、本当に私の生活の場を奪おうとしていますけれども、真実を必ず明らかにしていきます。
And so he is, you know, through his words at the moment as well, trying to even go as far and make it seem that I am lying and try to take away from me my livelihood, even my place to live. However, I'm certain that through these proceedings, the truth will come to light.
Thank you very much. Well, we are out of time. In fact, we're well over time. So we do have to end it there. My apologies to people who wanted to ask questions. Thanks so much to Arai-san for coming today to give a press conference, which must have been very difficult, we understand. And thanks to Mary Joyce, of course, for, as always, a sterling interpretation job.Arai-san, we have a tradition here of offering you a membership of the club.
こちら1年間の名誉会員証をお渡ししますが、本日は本当に、まあ、辛い話をしていただき、本当にありがとうございます。
Perhaps Arai-san will come back next year and tell us how her court case is going.
また来年でもまた裁判の続きなどの報告もしていただければと思います。またよろしくお願いします。
本当にありがとうございました。
こちらこそ今日はどうも本当にありがとうございました。
Thank you very much for the opportunity today.